idea when emergency medical assistance first started is that the dollar fifty charge would cover the operations, and most governments are now having to subsidize those out of the general funds. We are currently subsidizing 911, only $800,000.
Whatever happened with the bill that the ACCG was pushing for those funds to be released from the state back down, did that bill get through? That was last year's deal, yeah.
We met requirements for that, which is if money back on.
Are we getting?
We got some.
Do we think we're getting what we're supposed to be getting? No.
What do we need?
Well, $800,000 more than we're getting.
Yeah, good.
Over the questions, the question I have, who sets the rate? Is that set by legislature?
Yes.
No.
We don't have to call it. But in order to say, are we getting what we need, we don't ask, it's very difficult, no. You tell them yourself, I'm about.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Once you're on this use right now, that somebody buys a cell phone someplace in the name, you can. We're not sure of that, so it's very difficult.
For years, the state was hanging on to that dollar fifty, not transferring it through, they were going into their budget numbers.
Yeah, that was our first meeting we had.
Yeah.
Ashley asked, I think it was Tim.
Look, is this something that warrants discussion with the delegation to see if we can get some movement on this?
It certainly wants a continued discussion of where the issue is.
Are we going to later on in the meeting get an update on the status of the CDBG grant?
I mean, just all the CDBG, how they suggest that, how they come on the construction. We could do all the.
I haven't been out there, so.
You know what?
That took you.
We'd be glad to replace it. All of my services. You're being tough, you know. Let me see that.
Capital project funds, again, we have the CDBGs that are for capital projects. The CHIP grant actually closed out in 2013, or ended in 2012. We just had a little bit still lagging in 2013, but that's basically gone away. The other one is, of course, for the Haven construction. And then also all your SPOS accounts are in here. SPOS 4 is still open. It has about $7,400 in it, and it all belongs to the city of Dasher, and we have asked them three times over the street that I'll see if we can close that grant out.
They got a roundabout they have put in down there that the citizens of Dasher are very confused about. They haven't got the arrows painted around the circle yet.
I don't understand.
Just stay right. They're actually putting up a barricade across part of Johnston Road, so it actually could take a barricade probably across Johnston Road coming off of 41.
SPOS 5 has about $3.6 million in it. Most of that belongs to the other cities. The county has two small parts of it there, but there's no red money left in there.
Part of the money is SPOS 5. Marcus is 4.
SPOS 5?
Yes, that's money out. Those are all. And that's city.
Just to clarify, in SPOS 4 and 5, that was before the SPOS policy changed, and the county was required to keep all the money for all the cities, and we're responsible for making sure that their expenditures meet our agreement. And SPOS 6 was also changed. first of all, we don't budget to use fund balance. I'm very conservative in our budgeting, so that when unexpected things come up, we can usually take care of them. We don't have to look at that fund balance. Sometimes it happens, and sometimes it may take a little bit of fund balance, but we try not to look at that each year. The county policy, we actually increased our policy from 90 to 120 days a few years ago.
I've been working on that for an hour.
You did good.
Change any pages, did you? I tried to contain it all.
So, we're in pretty solid financial shape. That doesn't mean we can go out for a long time, but we've been able to come through a lot better than some of our other governments have. But, you know, of course, we have some issues with vehicles and equipment and with costs that are out and like fuel and energy. And we have some other things that are going to impact the revenues, and we just don't know what kind of impact those are going to have some of the changes in tax laws on. The next couple of pages, there's some charts. Your local option sales tax and your SLOPs. Just so you can see where the choices were versus what happened to them in the last 5 years. We have, if you look at the history of sales tax, on average, we saw about 8% growth every year up until this last loss in this election, and then it drops off dramatically. So we're expecting about 75% of what we originally anticipated on that. 2013 is not quite where 2012 was. There's a couple months left, and I'd say hopefully we'll keep back up and at least be comparable to last year. It is showing some growth.
Might be too early to tell, maybe not, we're halfway through, but are we anticipating having to secure a can this year? A can is a loan we get from the bank, it's called a tax anticipation notice or note. So in case tax revenues are lower than expected, you've got a loan covered.
Well, it's a cash flow because your revenues don't come in on your property taxes until usually November, December, but your budget starts in July, so people start, you know, buying things. And to fund that cash, you get a tax exemption credit that's borrowed against those tax revenues, and then you have to pay it off by December.
The bubble is called a credit line.
That's what I'm
exactly what it is.
How are these funds collected and handled? I noticed this, you know, like swaps and sales tax. Tell me the channel once from point of sale to
everything
each city
is sent to the Department of Revenue.
The state.
Right. Yeah. On the local option sales tax, the Department of Revenue sends each government its share based on the current agreement.
So they'll send the city of Valdosta so much and the county so much. So we don't have to
it's
disperse
all the cities their amount. On the special purpose local option sales tax, it sends it all to the county, and the county is responsible for sending it out to all the cities. And we have an agreement that within 10 days of us receiving it, we will have it sent out to each city.
And the really interesting thing is our 1 cent sales tax and the school's 1 cent sales tax allocations back from the state do not equal each other.
And they should be.
They should be. The school boards have a fit about that. The school boards have a fit about that.
What's the explanation for that?
The state can't explain it.
There's a tax force.
It's crazy, and
I've heard that,
even if you look at the loss and the SLOPs, the growth rates are not the same every year. couple of things that are coming out of this bag. First of all, your law of negotiation. Well, they, and that has an impact on taxpayers. The other part is the tax, one of the, you have the energy tax on manufacturing that goes away. You have the option of putting in an excise tax on that. The other one is the vehicle taxes. Instead of March 2013, you're not going to pay a sales tax when you purchase vehicles. You have a title tax that you pay one time, and you won't have the annual ad valorem. And there's a percentage that goes to the state, and that goes back to the local government. They're taken until 2000.